What an exciting time in a believer's life. What an exciting time of the year. I told someone recently Christmas and Easter are my favorite times of year. Not necessarily just, I mean, it is awesome, and how appropriate to be celebrating a new life when new life is happening all around us. How about it? I was thinking, just as Brother Spoh was exhorting there, I read on Facebook this afternoon, I have a friend, put it that way, a friend that is involved in the financial world, and he posted something, and he said, I am on a financial website right now, looking at all the stocks, and everything, and all the activity that's going on, or the inactivity that's going on around the world today. The financial market, there's nothing going on. It's all stopped.
Praise God.
And we are, you know, I know we get discouraged because our country's not what it used to be and our world's not what it used to be, but guess what? Stuff stops on Good Friday. And it's just a testament to show that there are still a group of people that believe that there should be some break in the activity that goes on in the world to let and to be an observance to this day. I saw another part, somebody said it was a little comic strip, and you can think it's funny, but this person said, why is it called Good Friday? And the little cartoon character said, well, if you were supposed to be on that cross and somebody took your place, what would you call it? You call it good. You call that person good. So just worship with me. I know you probably know the song that I'm going to sing, and I don't care. You can sing along with me. But when he was on the cross, I was on his mind. So unworthy of such mercy. But when he was on the cross, I was on his mind. Really, that cross was for me. Really, that cross was for you. Think about it. Cross was for you. Nobody else. Because that's how we make it personal. That's how we go to Calvary. Is when we put everybody else aside. I don't need people to survive. Although you all know, if you know me, I'm a people person and I thrive with people around me. But I don't need people. I need Jesus. Cross he bore, the crowds thorns were on his head.
Thank you. between you and God if you bring your sin to the cross. If you bring those things that hurt and trouble you to the foot of the cross, there is nothing that is too great, nothing that is too powerful, for at the foot of the cross, where the blood is fallen, the blood cleanses, the blood saves, and there still is power to give great deliverance, even in this hour. There is nothing too hard for the Lord your God, through the Lord Jesus Christ and what he has done.